Hello everyone, and welcome to this pre-recorded presentation for The Cutting Season by Attica Locke. This pre-recorded session is all about introducing you to The Cutting Season by Attica Locke, which has been added to the Paper Tooth prose theme, Crime and Detection. In this session you will learn more about The Cutting Season and the main themes of the novel, look at the assessment and how the assessment objectives are approached, discover how students from past series have performed on Paper 2, explore activities around teaching the text on Paper 2, and learn more about the support available for this text on the Pearson website. Let's start by looking at a quick overview of the novel and its themes. These have been taken from an introductory guide on the website, which you can download. There is a link to this and all the other resources I will be discussing today on each slide. This is a very brief summary of the novel taken from the guide on the Pearson website. You may want to pause the recording to read this and restart again when you are ready. This is an extract from the specification explaining the requirements for this paper. So as you can see, the component has a thematic focus and students have a choice of two thematically linked texts. The Cutting Season is a new text which has been introduced to replace The Murder Room and is first assessed for A-level in summer 2024. There are some important requirements to remember here. At least one of the texts studied in the chosen theme must be selected from pre-1900 option. So for Crime and Detection, you must pair The Cutting Season with either Lady Audley's Secret or The Moonstone to fulfil this requirement of the specification. These are some of the themes identified in the guide on the Pearson website. So the novel covers a lot of ground, and there are many themes and contexts that your students will want to explore and study. This is a podcast interview with the author on YouTube, in which she discusses The Cutting Season and its themes. You may want to pause the recording and listen to this now. Or, if you would like to listen to this later and use some other resources, the link to this podcast can be found in the guide on the Pearson website. I'm now going to look at what is assessed in Paper 2, Prose, and the assessment objectives you should aim to focus on in your teaching. So let's start by looking at what is assessed. This box has been taken from page 2 of the A-level specification and is the overview of assessment for Paper 2. Paper 2 focuses on prose and is a written exam lasting 1 hour and 15 minutes. In this paper, students compare two prose texts from a chosen theme, and at least one of the prose texts must be pre-1900. Students answer one comparative essay from a choice of two on their studied theme, and the total number of marks available is 40. The question assesses A01, A02, A03 and A04. And here are the AOs that the question focuses on. So it's A01, articulate informed, personal and creative responses to literary texts using associated concepts and terminology and coherent, accurate written expression. A02, analyse ways in which meanings are shaped in literary texts. A03, demonstrate understanding of the significance and influence of the context in which literary texts are written and received. And A04, explore connections across literary texts. There are two sets of questions available on the website. These are the questions from the SAMS, or the sample assessment materials. The link to this paper is on the bottom of the slide. As you can see, there is a choice of question, so let's look at these in more detail. The first question here starts with the phrase, compare the ways in which the writers of your two chosen texts use, which encourages students to focus on A01, A02 and A04. The second question starts with the phrase, compare the ways in which the writers of your two chosen texts present, which also encourages students to focus on A01, A02 and A04. Both questions then have a second sentence, you must relate your discussion to relevant contextual factors, which directs students to A03. The questions on the previous slide focused on how the writers of the students' chosen texts use dialogue and present motive, or the lack of it, for committing crime. This is the indicative content for question 5. how the writers of the students' chosen texts use dialogue. As you can see from the line at the bottom, these are suggestions only, and any valid response is accepted. You may want to pause this recording and read the indicative content here and make a note of how it incorporates the four assessment objectives. And here is another set of questions from the EAMS or specimen papers, which can be found by following the link at the bottom of this slide. Here, students have the choice between comparing the ways the writers of their chosen text present communities or explore the effects of the past on the present. And here is the indicative content for the question about the ways the writers present communities. Again, you may want to pause this recording and read the indicative content here and make a note of how it incorporates the four assessment objectives. So as well as using the indicative content for guidance, the examiner marks the work using levels-based mark schemes. On this slide, I have included the descriptors for the first grid, which covers AO1 and AO2. Now it's a little bit small, so you may want to use the mark scheme which can be found in the SAMS by following the link on the slides. As you can see, there are some descriptors in bold at the start of each level. So level 1 is descriptive, level 2 is general understanding / exploration, level 3 is clear relevant application / exploration, level 4 is discriminating controlled application / exploration, and level 5 is critical and evaluative. And there are two bullets to address each assessment objective. So bullet 1 is AO1 and focuses on how students have articulated their arguments, their use of examples from the text, their use of terminology and concepts, the structure of the essay, and their expression. And bullet 2 is AO2 and focuses on how students have discussed the writer's craft and how meanings are shaped in texts. You may want to pause the recording now to read this grid in more detail and see what is expected of students at the different levels. Let's look now at the second grid. This one addresses AO3 and AO4. As you can see, there are the same descriptors in bold to ensure consistency, and there are two bullets to address each of the assessment objectives. Bullet 1 is AO3 and focuses on how students have discussed the significance and influence of contextual factors and made links between the texts and their contexts. Bullet 2 is AO4 and discusses the connections made between the texts and how integrated the approach and use of examples from the text is. Now we have looked at what is assessed in the exam questions, let's move on to some feedback from the examiners from previous exam series. This was taken from the end of the examiner report for A-level for Paper 2 from 2022. In the paper summary at the end of the report, the principal examiner sums up some feedback about the whole paper and offers some advice for candidates. You may want to pause the recording now to read this slide. It is general feedback and is from page 117 of the report. As you can see, there's some helpful advice here around each of the assessment objectives. It's worth downloading and reading the Summer 2022 Examiner Report in full, as there are many other useful pieces of feedback. This report can be found by using the link below, and there are examiner reports for all of the series on the website. And here are some resources for students on Paper 2. This is a screenshot from a PDF which has some embedded videos of the principal examiner giving some advice to students about Paper 2. The document with the links to all of the videos can be downloaded using the link at the bottom of this slide. Now we have seen what is required, the next few slides will talk you through how to start to approach the teaching of this text in the classroom using resources from the Pearson website. This is a screenshot from the scheme of work from the website. As you can see, this is the second page of the scheme of work and gives some suggestions about how to introduce the text as well as how to approach teaching the whole text. The next page gives some advice around how to teach comparison. This scheme of work can be downloaded by using the link at the bottom of the slide. This is a useful pack on the website around teaching prose. It has some interesting questions and things to consider around teaching prose and the different elements you may wish to consider when approaching this paper. This is a screenshot from the slides around AO2 and the whole pack can be downloaded by clicking the link on the slide. There is also a lesson plan on the website around exploring prose comparison. There is a note of caution here as it was written using two texts from a different theme, but as you can see from the screenshot of the first page here, the extracts in the resources can be used to introduce close comparison, or the resource can be adapted to fit your two text choices. There is also a lesson plan around introducing crime and detection as a theme or genre to your students. As you can see from the screenshot here, the lesson is focused on the genre and may provide some useful background for your students as they start this component. And these are some useful links from the guide to introduce the text to students. You can download this guide using the link on the slide. Now that we have discussed the novel, the assessment, and some possible ways to approach the text, let's finish off by looking at the support for this text and the rest of the A-level course. Here is the list of the materials with links that I have used for this recording. There are other resources on other papers and sections of the qualification, which can all be found in the teaching and learning area of our website. This is the information for our subject advisor, Claire Haviland. She can be reached on the contact details below, and you can also sign up for her regular subject advisor updates, as well as booking a free 20-minute video appointment. We offer a lot of courses throughout the school year, and you can sign up for these via the Pearson Professional Development Academy. Thank you very much for listening, and I do hope this information was useful.